From Careco TV, one of the longest running outdoor programs on television today. Exploring the country and the coast in search of adventure. From the mountains of the Great Northwest to the shores of the Atlantic Ocean, this is Americana Outdoors, presented by Garmin. This week on Americana Outdoors, we're taking some Thompson Center Encores out to the field with some special guests for a few whitetail hunts in a short series of quests for getting that perfect shot. But first, Wade is going to hit up some ponds both in the boat and on the bank for some instructional fun fishing for largemouth bass. Today, we'll begin our first pond visit to the Nuna Ranch in Texas.
You know, strategy-wise on this trip here, the bass were shallow. They're setting up this pond. We got temperatures that are closing in on 80 degrees and a lot of low pressure in the area. There's actually a front and heavy rain coming tonight. The bass are ready to spawn. So when they get that bank shallow, it's not hard to catch them in a pond.
Basically a little trick worm out there and rigging it out. And what a deadly, you know, bait combination to just be kind of throwing on in this type of a situation. I'll talk a whole lot more about baits and how I'm catching them, but you know, pond fishing at its simplest is fairly easy to do. You don't need a ton of gear. When you look at a place like this, I don't think there's anybody watching this show right now that wouldn't feel pretty good about sitting out on their back dock and having this right there. Soft plastic, so I always pan out. You just can keep it very very simple. Ooh, there's a good one. Golly, get on over here. Oh, jump over here to me. How about that?
I'm fishing a Cabela's Fisherman Series go-to worm, a finesse worm, basically wacky style. It's watermelon with purple swirls, mimics these bluegill and little bait fish that are living in this body of water to a T. I'm throwing it out, obviously with no weight, and I've got the hook right in the middle. I'm moving it around because I've caught so many fish off of it, but I'm using 7-pound test Sunline Sniper. I want to use fluorocarbon because I want line that sinks for this presentation, and the presentation is so natural as that bait falls down in the water column. For a rod, I'm using one of the Tournament ZX spinning rods with a Prodigy reel, and the whole overall setup of what I've got rigged up here is just absolutely perfect for an afternoon of pond fishing. Oh, yeah! Hook perfect right in the top of the mouth. Come here, darling. Well, that's what I'm talking about right there. That's so much fun. So when you get into the management aspect of some of these ponds, you know, you have to remove a lot of fish. So, you know, there's places that we'll go where we're keeping every fish under, you know, 12 or 14 inches because that's their goal. And then there's other places where they want to get a lot of bites like this right here. I mean, they love the fact that there's a tremendous amount of fish in this body of water and people can come here and basically do like what I'm doing and get bit. But when you look at fishing these ponds, I mean, right now I'm looking at a school of about 25 bluegill and bass around my bait. And the bass I'm actually trying to catch is chasing bluegill out of his spawning area. He's trying to push him out. Look at that good one there. Golly, isn't that cool? Golly. Oh yeah. Come here. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. I use these little mini hooks like that for that bait right there. I can pop down there and pop that sucker out real fast. Give myself a little slack. That was so cool. I've been fishing for this fish for a little bit, 10 or 15 minutes. Finally got it to bite. We're gonna let this one go back. You can see the little copper flecks up there. That's so pretty. Clear water. Ponds are just something that are such a cool place for people to fish. You know, whether you're fishing a little bitty one like this, whether it's something used as a stock tank to water cattle, or whether it's somebody's private playground where they've got some giants living in it. So no matter whether it's a Camelot Bell or out here at the Nuna Ranch right behind their dove hunting operation, fishing a pond, it's a lot of fun.
When we return, we join Wade and Elite Series pro Kelly Jordan out on the water in Camelot Bell. For your next fishing trip, head to Cabela's and check out their line of Cabela's guidewear for a comfortable day on or off the water, regardless of the conditions.
Gill that I've used for the last 5 years has been a far superior product than anything else on the market.
The main thing that's really important to me is me being dry. I've been wearing Gill suits now for 3 years and never once have I gotten wet.
When you pack your cooler for a barbecue or even a tailgate party, be sure to pack it with Chillin' Brew, powered by Arctic Ice. Chillin' Brew in a cooler can keep beer at the perfect drinking temperature longer than ice. Grab some brews and Chillin' Brew today.
My secret weapon? Evercom.
It's the first ever calming scent.
It's real smells from bedding areas.
To deer, that means safety.
Evercom reassures even nervous deer,
which can help you get the shot.
I use Evercom all season long.
Put it on your boots, your pants, and your decoy.
It's stick form, won't wash away or freeze.
Evercom.
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 From the Family Deer Farm at Conquest Scents.
Engineered to excel, the Ranger Z500 and Z100 series are built for the ultimate ownership experience. It's a commitment to excellence packed with real-world advantages and exclusive features. Experience the accelerated performance standards of the legendary Ranger Z series. From first light to last cast, they're put together to set you apart. Yamaha Outboards. Reliability starts here. Member of the Yamaha off-road family. It thrives in the most remote, rugged terrain. It never steps down from a challenge and travels long distances in search of adventure. The all-new Yamaha Wolverine. It's a whole new animal.
The Panoptix is the future of fishing. We can see our lures coming in. We can choose the proper lures for the depth of fish are in. It makes fishing so much easier when you go to a new body of water because now you can really identify with the bass, figure out where they're feeding, what depth they're at, and really learn how they're reacting to your lures. To be able to see that kind of stuff and understand it and then interpret it, put it into your game, unbelievable.
Americana Outdoors, presented by Garmin, is brought to you by Garmin, fight your fish, not your fish finder. Cabela's, it's in your nature. Chillin' Brew, the coolest addition to your cooler.
Kelly Jordan and I go back a long way. We've had a great opportunity to fish together many times. Not only is he a dear friend, he's a good friend in the industry as well. So when we get a chance to spend time on the water, it's always fun. And so when Kelly got me the invite to come down to Camelot Bell, there was a lot of things that were intriguing to me. Number one, my past passion for being involved with fishing around bodies of water like this and the management aspects that go into them.
It's the right habitat, it's the right management, and it's strictly managing for that big fish. That's what Mr. Mike Frazier does here at Camelot Bell. He has one goal in mind, and that's growing super bass, having them in his lake. He's got the skins on the wall to prove it, and he has done that, and I have been here fishing several times. Every time I get to come here, it's a treat, and I'll tell you what, truly, every cast you make could be that cast.
It took a lot of bait. It took a lot of management, but we're here now. And I take a lot of fish out. When we fish today, you're gonna really be surprised at what you see on the way that you can manage a properly balanced pond that's not eaten up by predators. We're gonna take out the fish, and we're gonna manage the lake the way that everyone should be able to do.
I don't know, he's just mean.
Come here, buddy.
Oh, nice.
Look how pretty they are.
I know.
Look at that. See how they got blue on them? Look at here by his face. See that blue? It's awesome.
Wow. Well, that's too cool.
You know, what's interesting to me is you can go to the best bodies of water in the nation, and Mother Nature is still going to play a big role whether you catch them or not. You got to fish it the way your gut tells you, just like you would a big lake. You know, whether you're going to throw 10-inch worms trying to get big bites, or whether you're going to throw small crankbaits. And, you know, as you determine those things and you begin to get bites, you kind of figure out from there what to throw, how to throw it, and what's going to pay off for you.
Oh. Yeah.
Got it.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Sweet. There's a couple of them up on that flat this morning.
That's what you're looking for. Look at how deep the girth is on that bass. Going down and square here. That's where they get their weight on this sucker.
Wow. Yeah.
We're fishing early here. It's, you know, pretty early in the morning. And that fish probably was in a foot and a half or 2 feet of water.
After wrapping up his trip with Kelly Jordan, Wade's already on his way to another pond fishing destination.
You know, the trip I'm getting ready to do now, I'm going with my old friend Mike Ox, and we're out by Sabinal, Texas. And this particular body of water is absolutely full of fish.
The great thing about fishing a pond is they got to be right there. They can't go anywhere. You don't need a big, fast boat. You don't have to run all over the place. If you're fishing that pond and there's fish in it, they're right in front of you. And you can stay really basic. You know, most places you go, a topwater bait, a spinner bait, plastic worm. If you stay with those three right there, you got it made. And the bass actually get kind of skinny in the summertime, and then in the wintertime when the grass all dies out, they fatten up. So really the best time to fish on these ponds is not in the summertime, it's in the wintertime during deer season. But you know what happens during deer season on a ranch in South Texas. That's usually not an option. There he is. Right there in that hole.
Yeah. There was another one just swam off.
Oh,
yeah. No,
get off
her
feet.
We tried. This is pond fishing at its best.
Yes, that's right.
This is the way it's,
fishing's supposed to be fun. You know, it's not supposed to be one of those deals where you've got to go out there and sweat.
Yep. I'm gonna have to change
all day long. You're trying to get two bites and that's garbage.
This makes it fun when you can just throw out there and catch them. These are fun bass. This is what you think of when you think of a private pond somewhere that not getting the pressure. You're just gonna get a lot of bites.
Well, after having some fun on the water, Wade's about to hit deer camp for some whitetail. Stay with us, will ya? Hey, before you hit the fields, be sure to check out Cabela's own Camo Zones Patterns product line. You can view all of them online at cabelas.com.
You know, a good knife is something that you can't ever underestimate the importance of. That's why when we found out about Bubba Blade a couple years ago, it was just like this eye-opening experience. We now had a knife that could do everything we needed to do. And it didn't matter what we were doing. It didn't matter whether we were cutting pizza at home, cutting up salami, or cleaning deer. It didn't matter whether we were cleaning or filleting the roughest fish we'd ever dealt with. It handled everything we needed it to do.
To learn more about the Bubba Blade, visit their website at bubbablade.com. After your next successful fishing trip, savor the flavor with a Bradley Smoker. They have a whole list of creative recipes for catch with a wide variety of delicious smoky wood flavors. Find out more about making your meal as memorable as the fishing trip at bradleysmoker.com.
Fast, affordable, and incredibly light. The all-new Shadow Ultralight from 10 Point. The lightest and most compact crossbow on the market today. 10 Point. There is no substitute.
Experience Sightviz, a brighter sight picture than standard sights, giving you an immediate, more successful shooting performance. Hi-Viz lets you see a dramatic contrast between the target and the barrel for a more intuitive aim that delivers instant results. Our light pipes come in a variety of shapes, sizes, and colors, designed to be seen in a variety of conditions. With our broad line of sights, you'll see your marksmanship dramatically improve, bringing more fun and confidence into every shooting experience. Shoot more accurately. Enjoy the sport. Choose Hi-Viz.
Heavy duty, rugged, and designed for the big game hunter and angler. The FoodSaver GameSaver Titanium Vacuum Sealer has the power and performance to seal in the freshness of your game and fish for up to 3 years, five times longer than standard storage methods. And with its extra-wide dual and repetitive sealing capabilities, that's a ton of big game savings. Tough-tested and rated 4.8 out of 5 stars by outdoorsmen just like you. The FoodSaver Titanium System, it's a true game changer.
At Amphibia, we've resolved to build a product that nobody else offers, using methods that nobody else is using, optimized for life on water and land. The choice of top bass fishing pros. Amphibia frames are designed to fit comfortably no matter how your face is shaped, to stay firmly in place through your most physical activities, and to float in water. Amphibia sunglasses are truly designed for life on the water.
Nikon's no-fault policy was created for those who continually push the envelope, travel the farthest, stay the longest, brave the most hostile elements. We do our best to deliver on our promise of a lifetime of performance. And we'll stand with you should accidents happen. Trust earned. Nikon. Comfortable to carry, comfortable to shoot. It's slim, concealable, and powerful protection. The M&P Shield by Smith & Wesson. Confidence? We perfected that years ago.
Americana Outdoors, presented by Garmin, is brought to you by Thompson Center, America's master gun maker. Nikon Sport Optics. Trust earned. Nikon. Hi-Viz Shooting Systems. See what you've been missing. Food Saver, the number one vacuum sealing system. Welcome back to Americana Outdoors. We're in South Texas with Wade and his guest Paul Pluff from Smith & Wesson. Paul is an avid hunter who enjoys targeting his big bucks with a pistol. Today, Wade is going to demonstrate how to rattle in a trophy buck for Paul.
Wade kinda came in and asked me if I wanted to go out and do some rattling, see if we could rattle some bucks in. And it's something that Wade and I have been doing for the last few years.
You know, rattling in a two-man formation, kinda like what we're doing here, is something that requires a little bit of a communication. And we've made mistakes like this. Paul and I are addicted to this type of hunting style. We have done this several times. We've rattled in some great bucks in the past. We enjoy this type of hunting because it's action-packed. We're always got something going on, and even when we're rattling and don't get anything in an area, we still had what we call a successful set, and we're moving to the next one with equally high hope. You know, some tips that I always have when it comes to rattling. No doubt about it, that you got to pay attention to the time of the year. You know, early in the year or late in the year, probably tinkling a little bit is going to be more successful than banging them hard in the peak of the rut. When deer are really in the peak of the rut and they're trying to set up their dominant, they fight hard. You know, I'm going to ease up into a mesquite bush, I'm going to ease up into something, and the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to start throwing rocks, I'm going to start stamping, I'm going to bang in the tree. You know, the first things that happen are deer are posturing, you know, they're kicking the ground. Think about a couple of dogs fighting.
Now, Paul is hunting with his Thompson Center Encore Pro Hunter pistol. This Thompson Center platform is interchangeable with a multitude of stock options, frames, and barrel configurations available. You can find out more at tcarms.com. And it looks like a deer is about to stare down the barrel of one.
as we set up on this little corner of this flat where I had been seeing a lot of deer chasing does, I knew we were probably gonna get a response. What deer may show up, I really had no idea. But as I hit the antlers together, man, an old big one came in.
When you're in the rut season like we are here, they come in like a laser ship. I mean, they just rocketed right into there.
I don't know. You know, when somebody misses, it's okay. Things happen, buck fever. I mean, just whatever happens, who knows? Misses always happen, but I would sure rather see a clean miss than I would see a shot that, you know, nicks an animal or wounds one. But in that case right there, as Paul dropped that hammer on there, I had already seen this buck hit the ground in my mind. I was already like, oh, we got him, because that buck came on a string. I mean, when you script the way a buck comes to antlers, that was it. So as you look at rattling as a hunting technique, keep a few things in mind, like I've always talked about. Early in the season, I like to tinkle the horns. If you're hunting an area where there's not necessarily absolutely giant bucks, don't make noise like probably you saw me do on this little piece here, where I'm trying to simulate bucks 140, 150, 160 inches. I'm trying to simulate a big buck fight. If you have the option, use real antlers. I'm a big believer in that. The sound, the cadence, the tone, even the smoke that we talk about that can be generated when real antlers are rubbing together, all play a big factor in that. And once again, I'm not saying you can't have success with rattling bags or the little hand rattling sets, because you can. It's just a personal preference on what I like. But know for a fact that rattling in a lot of different hunting situations on the ground, the way we do it, moving around in a tree stand, is a deadly technique to be able to call in some great whitetail deer.
Well, you can bet Paul will be back next year to take another shot at a Texas whitetail. When we return, we join Wade and Danielle Sandville, who are looking for their perfect shot of the season. But first, Americana Outdoors encourages you to check out Dead Deer Shooting Sticks for an easy-to-use, safe, and stable option, whether you're standing, kneeling, or sitting. Check them out on their website below for more information. Provide the ultimate lightweight fishing platforms that will offer anyone what they want when it comes time to hit the water. Hobie Kayak's commitment to innovation, quality, and owner satisfaction is unparalleled in the industry. So when it's time for you to go kayaking, remember there's only one name to remember, and that's Hobie Kayak.
Engel's got the original high-performance cooler and a whole lot more. Engel coolers, go with the original.
Stealth Cam, trail cameras with features you demand, with the durability and performance you can count on. Built to withstand even the harshest conditions. Stealth Cam, join the trail cam revolution.
The world's best fishing line is now available in the United States. Sunline FX2, the strongest braid available.
Son, this braid, Oh, absolutely love it.
Reliable, proven. Until there's no more ground to cover and no more stories to tell. When you're a TC Venture Hunter, the hunt never ends.
Americana Outdoors, presented by Garmin, is brought to you by Yamaha ATV. Real world tough. Do all outdoors. Innovative gear for the hunter and shooter. Stealth Cam. Stealth Cam Digital Scouting Cameras. The game has changed. Welcome back to Americana Outdoors. Well, Wade has been capturing some great shots from his Stealth Cam as of late, with evidence of some quality bucks near one of his newer blinds. Let's join him as he tests out this new blind, affectionately called the Lizard Lounge.
I always think it's funny how certain stands in areas get their name, you know, and this one here, the Lizard Lounge, picks its name up because we were sitting in it and lizards were running all over the place and it was just so loud and we named it the Lizard Lounge. We didn't have a name for it before then, it was pretty new. After studying the scouting cameras in this particular setup, I mean, there was no doubt the Lizard Lounge had a lot of game coming in and out of it. I mean, they were coming from a lot of different angles, a lot of different age classes of bucks. And as I went out to go sit in the stand, I had a very open mind. I was wide open on expectations, what might happen, what I might see even. So, you know, when you can go hunting like that, that's my favorite way to go.
Now, within an hour or so of Wade getting settled into the Lizard Lounge, a nice 7-point comes out into view. But as Wade is trying to get a shot on him, well, it looks like his buck has other things in mind.
When you start setting up in situations where you've got a lot of deer and a lot of rutting activity going on, it can get pretty hectic and pretty crazy pretty fast. You know, the bucks were basically trying to cut these does out off to the side, and the does were just trying to come in and get a little nibble of something to eat, get a drink, whatever. And it was a pretty target-rich environment.
After watching the buck rut around for a while, another buck comes in to investigate the action.
You know, hunting in Texas is something that's really special because our deer density and quality of the deer, due to all the hard work that a lot of the ranchers and the leasers and people that hunt on it have put in, it's special. And I'm watching a couple of these bucks and I'm really kind of thinking I'm gonna take this one buck out. I had seen him a lot all year long and I liked his rack. I mean, he's a good one. You know, when you make a great shot and it drops right there, as a hunter, that is one of the best feelings.
He is down, down, down. Here is the end result of one that we just, boom, flopped right here, boys. I mean, that is a good buck right there. Good mass, good tines, kind of come right up together. I like that. I couldn't resist him. I mean, what a great buck.
Americana Outdoors proudly uses Thompson Center Encore as their choice for hunting rifles. With a wide variety to choose from, TC Arms provides a great made in America quality and reliability that you deserve when out in the field. Now, let's join Danielle Sandville, who's also looking for a lucky shot today.
I get the gun up on the rail and I kind of get hunkered back into the seat, and Jeff suggests that I kind of lean my elbow against the rail so it'll give me some extra support. And then within another 2 minutes, out of the corner of my eye, I see this big guy, and he's walking far behind, and he walks all the way to the right, down, following a deer, following a doe, like chasing the doe. My eyeballs grew, and he says, "Yep, that's the one." So I decide that I'm gonna take this guy. And so I cock the gun back and I get my finger on the trigger and I wait for that perfect opportunity where that first buck is out of the way and he is broadsided to us and I got that perfect shot. Man, that buck just dropped. Like, 308 Encore dropped that buck. He did not move.
Now that's what a 308 does.
When I walked up on him and saw how big he was, I was just, it was just a feeling of just being proud of myself and accomplishing something and being able to put meat in the freezer and share it with friends. And at Thompson Center in Smith & Wesson, we actually have a game dinner and we use all of the meat as well for those types of situations where the game dinner, the proceeds from the game dinner go to local charities.
This was just awesome. I mean, look at this guy.
Well, congratulations, Danielle, on another perfect shot for the day on Americana Outdoors. If you enjoyed the show, we encourage you to visit us online at AmericanaOutdoors.com for even more great stories from the field. And a special thanks to our sponsors for making today's show possible. Hey, if you're in the market for new gear, please support those that support us. Americana Outdoors is a Careco TV production. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.